If you're new, this video is going to be an addition to my series of videos about making reactive metals by the electrolysis of molten salts. So if you haven't seen any of my other videos on this topic, maybe check out at least one of these first, just so you know what's going on, but up to you, I suppose. At this point, we've made a few reactive metals by electrolysis, and next on my kind of arbitrary list of metals to extract is magnesium. Now, magnesium is actually one of the metals that is industrially produced by electrolysis, so we know that this reaction is at least possible to do. I have here magnesium chloride. We need an ionic salt of magnesium for the molten electrolysis to work, and chlorides are pretty good because they generally have relatively low melting points, and the reaction, the oxidation reaction that happens with chloride ions, is generally quite simple at high temperatures. To decrease the melting point of magnesium chloride, which is normally 714 degrees Celsius for the anhydrous stuff, I also have some potassium chloride, which I will be adding to the melt to make a eutectic mixture that instead melts at about 450 degrees Celsius. Luckily, potassium is much harder to extract by electrolysis than magnesium is, so adding it won't affect the production of magnesium metal. One really big issue, or possibly a big issue that might affect our production of magnesium in this experiment, is the fact that magnesium chloride is very hygroscopic. The magnesium chloride that I have is the hydrated form. In trying to melt the hydrated form of magnesium chloride, it doesn't actually dehydrate and then turn into the anhydrous magnesium chloride. Instead, it kind of decomposes a bit into oxides and oxychlorides. We're just going to pretend it's not an issue and we're going to try to melt this stuff anyway. We'll see what happens. When we apply electrolysis to our molten mixture, we expect the cathode, or the negative electrode, to reduce magnesium ions into magnesium metal. Likewise, we expect the anode, the positive electrode, to oxidize chloride ions, or something in there, to chlorine gas or something similar. Now, because it worked so well when we were making calcium in a previous video, I'm actually going to use the graphite crucible that we're going to melt everything in as the anode itself. We know that graphite is good at doing the chlorine evolution reaction at these temperatures, and additionally the high surface area should allow us to do the reaction quite quickly. For the cathode, we're just going to use a steel wire. It's worked in the past and it's easy to set up. And with that, I'm pretty sure I've talked through everything that I need to, so let's start electrolyzing. The trouble with melting down our magnesium chloride is, as you can see, I'm using the hexahydrate of the magnesium chloride salt, so there's a lot of water in there to boil out first, and you can see that's kind of violent, spraying a bunch of our magnesium chloride and potassium chloride all over the place, but hopefully that will boil off quite quickly and we will be left with the molten, mostly anhydrous, salt. All right, it was messy to melt everything down, as you can see by the state of my furnace, but we have now got our potassium chloride, magnesium chloride eutectic melted down in our graphite crucible. And as you might be able to see in there, I have turned the electrolysis on. We've got about an amp flowing through the cell now. I have successfully inserted the iron wire, the steel wire, as our cathode, and we've got a nice current flowing. As is usually the case at the very start of our electrolysis runs when we do these things with molten salts, there's a small amount of water in the molten mass that we have to electrolyze away before we can actually start to see any metal forming on the cathode. So I'm going to run and grab my mask. I'm going to turn the current up to maybe 8 amps. That's always a good current to aim for, I think. And then we're going to quickly electrolyze our water away and hopefully start to see some metal form on the cathode. Four volts, 8 amps. I've only done about 5 minutes of electrolysis here, and I'm starting to see, and I'm pretty sure you can too, quite a big kind of black chunk on the end of the cathode there. It looks like that's magnesium. I didn't really expect it to be this easy to make it, but I think that might be it. I'm going to leave the electrolysis running for as long as I can without any problems, and we'll see if we can extract that blob.
I think that might be magnesium. I think we might as well just keep going.
Now, the one issue here, I think, is that we're running this reaction at temperatures at which the magnesium metal is forming as a solid. In all of the other electrolysis or molten salt electrolysis experiments we've done, we formed the metal as a liquid, which has been easier to extract. I don't know whether I'm going to increase the temperature to make it a liquid or if I'm just going to try to grow solid magnesium on the cathode, because that does seem to be working well. All right, so I just scraped a little bit of what we think is magnesium off the wire that we have been using as the cathode. One thing we've noticed is that it is very dendritic, this metallic product. I'm pretty sure it's metallic, but it is really finely divided and it's really not very shiny. I have it on the end of this little scooper here. I don't know if you can see that very well. Focus. There we go. It's kind of black. It was shinier before, but I noticed something when I put it in some water, because normally magnesium doesn't react with water, right? It's a water stable metal, even though it's so reactive. So I was going to wash the magnesium using some water to get rid of any of the ionic salts, magnesium chloride and potassium chloride stuck to it. But I noticed that when I put it in water, you can kind of see it's actually reactive enough that it seems to bubble. Now, this isn't a very vigorous reaction, of course, so this isn't the kind of reaction that you'd see if this metal was potassium. But I'm thinking maybe we've made the magnesium in a fine enough powder, or at least a high enough surface area, that it is actually reacting with water here. Alright, a couple of short updates. I tried running the cell again at a higher temperature in order to make sure that the magnesium was forming as a liquid instead of a solid, so it would bead up nicely and we would be able to scoop it out. That didn't seem to work at all. We ran the electrolysis for maybe half an hour and it really looked like nothing was happening, so I turned things off and had a bit of a poke around inside the cell, and what I think has happened is all of the magnesium that we have made actually sinks to the bottom of the melt, which is very disappointing because it's really hard to extract that way. I scooped all the way down to the bottom of the cell and I was able to get more of this spongy stuff. I'm still pretty sure this is mostly magnesium metal, but it is really, it's in a very spongy form, and I'm pretty sure it's the same stuff that I showed you reacting with water before. So I've got another little piece right here and hopefully we will see that that reacts with water in exactly the same way that we saw before. It's not really showing up very vigorously, but that is bubbling with what I can only assume is hydrogen there, slowly reacting with the water. So yeah, I don't know. We can make this stuff. It's not really something that looks very much like magnesium, but I'm pretty sure it is magnesium metal for the most part. I'd really like to get a bead of pure metal though. That would be quite nice. So as a last resort, I've ran the cell for a little while to generate as much of what we think is magnesium as we can. And then I'm now turning it off and heating up the cell as hot as it will go to make sure that the magnesium sitting at the bottom of the cell will actually melt and coalesce into something a little bit nicer. To make sure that the magnesium actually melts and collects together and coalesces into something that's maybe a little bit nicer than this stuff that we've made.
I can see little beads of metal in there. just not very good ones.
About 24 hours later, I have disassembled our electrolysis apparatus and poured everything out of the cell, as you saw. I've made two piles. This pile is everything out of the cell that doesn't look like it has any magnesium in it. And this is the stuff in the cell that might have magnesium in it. I'm going to discard this pile. We're not going to worry about that. And then all of our important stuff is in this cluster, because this contains what we thought was our magnesium sponge. And it also, if you look really closely, you can definitely see, get that to focus properly, beads of what look like metal. And we're pretty sure that's going to be magnesium metal. Another good bit right here, just there, bead of magnesium. It is rather disappointing that most of our magnesium product is in the form of this weird kind of spongy stuff, because as we noted before, it is extremely reactive, and the stuff that I extracted from the cell initially, we get a look at that, you can see it's really turned kind of white. Looks to me like a bunch of magnesium oxide has formed due to the high surface area of the magnesium in this form. It's not really nice to look at as a sample of metal, in my opinion. So I think we were running the electrolysis kind of incorrectly when we were doing this. I should have been running everything at a high temperature to make sure the magnesium was forming in the molten state. And then I really wasn't expecting the magnesium metal to be more dense than the molten salt. Normally when we make these metals, they float on the top of the molten mass. But in this case, the magnesium was sinking to the bottom. So I'm thinking maybe we should have had something underneath the cathode to catch the magnesium as it was forming, or maybe we just should have used the crucible itself as the cathode to begin with. Either way, I'm not really too keen on setting everything up once more and trying again. It's a lot of work and I'd like to move on. So we're going to have to be happy with the small beads of magnesium that we can find in these chunks. Now, luckily for us, I think I've got a really good way to extract them, because as we saw before, this spongy magnesium product reacts with water, as does the magnesium chloride and the potassium chloride. All three of these things dissolve. So the magnesium metal, one of the few metals we've worked with so far that doesn't react with water, will be left behind if we just chuck these chunks into a beaker full of water. Much easier than trying to break apart these pieces and extract the actual beads themselves, I think. Just in case this does end up going horribly wrong, I did go ahead and extract one of the beads of magnesium, just so we've got one tiny little bit of yield if this reaction with water ends up destroying everything. I'm also going to wash out the crucible, because I had a look in there before and there's still a bunch of the spongy stuff in here and a bunch of beads of magnesium that I can also see. So hopefully we'll get some extracted from here as well. After washing our entire product with water, we're left with this muck. I'm going to call it. It's really just a bunch of grey sludge. I searched for hours through this stuff to try to find tiny little beads of magnesium. And happily, we did actually get some degree of product. You can see I've got this sitting in some water here. You'll note that it's not actually reacting with the water, which is what we expect from magnesium when it's not in its spongy, high surface area form. I went and also washed all of these beads with a little bit of acid very quickly to make sure they're nice and shiny, and you can see that they are. So it looks quite nice. It's clearly metal and it is magnesium. However, it's really, really not a very good yield. I think these are the big bits that I was able to find, so they were the easy ones to pick out. But I reckon this constitutes 5% or less of our total yield. Because so much of it was in the form of just microscopically small, shiny beads of magnesium that it was just impossible for me to separate them and actually pick them out and add it to our bunch of magnesium here. Just to give you a look at how small these beads actually are, this is what most of our magnesium looks like. It's in beads as small as this. I was able to separate out 7 or 8 beads of this size, but beyond this, I'm really not going to bother getting any more. This was a lot of effort to get, and it's really not worth it. Looks like 60 milligrams. I'm not looking forward to calculating the yield, but that will be going on the screen about now, I hope. And of course, one final test to show you that this is definitely magnesium metal. I've taken a very small portion of our yield, just one bead of magnesium right there. I don't want to use it all up. And I thought, why don't we try burning it? Because if it is magnesium, we blast it with a blowtorch, we will definitely know that it is magnesium. Wow, I wasn't expecting it to be quite that vigorous with such a small piece, but that was actually quite impressive. And finally, just to reflect on absolutely everything we've done so far, the successful production of magnesium metal brings our collection of metals extracted by molten salt electrolysis up to 5. Aluminium, sodium, lithium, calcium, and now magnesium. Still a little bit disappointed by the yield, but that, I think, is still a success. See you later.